Hey kids, welcome back to Clean Slate Farm. Today we're going to be building honey uncapping tanks for us honey scratchings when we do the extracting. And what I've got here is just a quick materials list. We have two plastic totes. These are about 16 inches wide, 24 inches long by about 7 inches deep. The depth, you can do whatever you want on the depth. I just chose 7 inches because they were cheap. We have some plastic window screen, not the metal kind, but the plastic window screen. We have a hole saw. We have a piece of wood that we're going to rip down and build some support braces and a cross brace, and that's about it. So let me set up the workshop. We're going to start working on the wood first, then we'll cut some holes in the bottom of one of these tanks. You'll see how this goes together. First thing I'm going to do is measure the width of the tank, which is 15 1/4 inches, but I want some overhang on that. So I'm going to go to 17 inches. So we're going to mark 17 inches. And we will cut the 17. Perfect. Then what we're going to do on a table saw, we're going to notch this out a little bit so it doesn't slide back and forth. So as I'm looking at my 17 inch piece to go across, I'm thinking that's kind of wide. So I'm going to narrow that down to, I'm thinking maybe 1 1/4 inches. 1 1/4 inches would be good. So let's get the blade up to height. See how it fits? It's perfect. Now what I'm going to do is mark it over. I got 17 inches on this, so I'm going to mark off 8 1/2, which is center point. And I'm going to drill a small hole, a pilot hole. That's done. Now we'll get our nail in there. And there we go. Now the frame sits on top like this. Okay, my next cut is going to be, I want to measure this. This piece of wood's going to rip in half and it's going to set inside. This is going to hold the one tank on top of the other. And we have 21 3/4, and I'm clear of that knot, so that's good. So we're going to cut this to length and then we're going to rip it. Okay, I've set the fence for 3/4 inches. Each of these is going to be 3/4 inches. Now, I don't have the anti-kickback and I don't have the blade guard on there, so if you see me doing something stupid and you think, boy, that's dumb, don't do it. I'm taking a chance, but we're going to do it anyway. Perfect fit. Let's cut the next one. Now, it just so happens this brand of tub has a raised bottom on it. You can see this right here. So what I'm going to do is on each corner, I'm going to drill a 1 3/8 hole with a hole saw. Take a straight edge razor, run it around the ends. Almost the last thing to do is to cut this mesh to fit in the bottom. So we're going to give it a measure. Straight edge here. How does this go together? Brace in there. Brace in there. Our screened bottom in here. Brace across the top, and we're good to go. Now there's only one thing left we have to do, and that is to put a honey gate on the bottom. So, honey gate, bottom, off to the races. I have to make my determination where I'm going to put the honey gate. Now there's a curved edge here, so I can't put it right tight against the bottom. And I don't want to put it in the middle because then I'm going to strain honey like this and we're going to have stuff left in the corners. I think what I want to do, move it over to one side. That way I can tilt the bucket this way and get more honey out of there. So we have a 1 3/4 inch hole again. And I'm just going to mark this off and start drilling. Clean that hole up a little bit. Good clean hole. Not much to clean up on that. Nice one. Put the honey gate in there. Hey, little handle thing there. That works out well. So there we go. Complete system for less than $20. I think I've probably got 15 bucks into it. Hey, thanks for watching Clean Slate Farm. I really appreciate it. If you like these videos, please subscribe, give them thumbs up. That'd be great too. And we'll see you later from Clean Slate Farm. Bye-bye.